Dear students, welcome to the video lecture of EST 102 Programming in C. These are the contents that we are going to discuss in this session. The main topic is pointers. Then we will see how to declare a pointer, accessing address of a variable, accessing data through pointers, what is null pointer, chain of pointers, which is also known as pointer to a pointer, then some pointer expressions, then array access using pointers, and in particular we are dealing with one dimensional array and simple programs covering pointers. So let's start the session. Pointer. Pointer is a variable which holds the address of some other variable, and this variable can be of type int, char, etc. Let's see one example. Here we have two variables, A and P. The value of A is 10 and the address of A is 64628. And we have a variable P, and the address of P is 6487628, and the value of P is 64628. And by checking this example, we can see that 6468 is the address of the variable A. So let's call P as a pointer, because P holds the address of the variable A. I repeat, P is a pointer because it holds the address of the variable A. Next is how to access address of a variable. The syntax is pointer variable equal to address of variable 2. For example, let's take the previous example. We have the pointer variable P, and we need to make a connection between the pointer variable to the address of some other variable. So for that, the syntax is pointer variable equal to address of the variable. So the example is P equal to address of A. So by this statement, we can make a connection between the pointer variable to the address of other variable A. Next is how to declare a pointer. In C language, the pointers can be declared using asterisk symbol, which is also known as indirection operator or dereferencing operator. Let's see one example. Int space star P semicolon. So by this statement, it denotes that P is a pointer variable of type int. Then next is how to access data through pointers. So let's take the same example. Here we have the variable A and P, and here P is the pointer variable because it holds the address of the variable A. And now we want to print the value of A through P. So for that, the statement is printf %d as asterisk P. Here the asterisk symbol can be read as value at P. So value at P, that is value at 64628, that is 10. So from this slide, there are three main points. First one is how to declare the pointer variable. The syntax is int, the example is int star P. So that is the first point. Second, after declaring a pointer variable, you have to make a connection between the pointer to the address of some other variable. And this is the example, P equal to address of A. Then third, if you want to access the data through the pointers, the syntax is, you have to, there is a printf statement, printf %d asterisk symbol P, that can be read as value at P. So these are the three main points from this slide. Let's look at one example, and here we have a program to print the value of A. Here I have declared two variables, A and P, and in the declaration part it is mentioned that P is a pointer variable and A is a variable which holds the value 45. And next is I have made a connection between the pointer variable to the variable A, and the statement is P equal to address of A. So this statement is very important. Then printf %d value at P. So by this statement, it will print the value of A through the pointer variable p. So we will get the output like this. 45 will be displayed on the screen. Next is null pointer. I have already mentioned that pointer variable always holds the address of some other variable. And if you don't have any address to be specified, you can mention it with null value at the time of declaration. And let's see one example. Int asterisk symbol p equal to null, semicolon. So by this statement, we are assigning, instead of assigning the address of one variable, we are assigning the null value. So this is an example of null pointer. The next topic is chain of pointers. In C language, it is possible to make a pointer pointing to another pointer. Thus, we can create the chain of pointers. And here is an example. We have the variable v1, p1 and p2. And the address of the variable v1 is address 1. The address of the variable p1 is address 2. The address of the variable p2 is address 3. So by analyzing this diagram, here the value of p1 is address 1. That is, p1 holds the address of the variable v1. So let's call p1 as a pointer variable. And also, p2 holds the value of address of p1 as its value. So p2 is a pointer which points to another pointer. So that is called chain of pointers, and it is also known as multiple indirections. And let's see the syntax of declaring chain of pointers. The syntax is data type, asterisk, double asterisk symbol, then pointer variable. So while declaring a pointer variable, we usually use one asterisk symbol. So in order to declare a pointer to a pointer, you have to use double asterisk symbol. Let's see one example. Int star star p2. So this denotes p2 is a pointer to a pointer of type int. So that's all about chain of pointers. Let's see one example. Here we have the main function and we have three variables, x, p1, p2. The value of x is equal to 100, and p1 is a pointer variable, and p2 is a pointer which points to another pointer. Okay, so after the declaration part, you have to make the connection between all these variables. So the statements are p1 equal to address of x. So by this statement, we are making a connection between the variable p1 to the address of x. Next is p2 equal to address of p1. So by this statement, we are connecting the pointer variables p2 and p1. And there is a printf statement, printf %d hyphen %d hyphen %d. The first %d will be replaced by value at p2. Then next %d will be replaced by value at p1. Then the last %d will be replaced by the value of x. So this is the output that we get after executing this program. The next is pass by reference method. In C language, between functions you can pass values, and that is called pass by value method. And instead of passing values, you can also pass address between the functions, and that can be accomplished using the concept of pointers. So suppose we have two functions and we want to pass address as a parameter to the next function, and in that case the formal parameters should be declared as pointer variable, because we are dealing with address in this case. And in this method, the address of the actual parameters is passed to the formal parameters. So the important thing is any change in the formal parameter will be reflected in the actual parameters. Let's see one example. This is the program to swap two numbers using pass by reference method. Here we are using pointers to implement this program. And inside the main function, I have declared another function called swap, and it is having two parameters. They are pointers p1 and p2. And inside the main function, I have declared two variables x and y. So through the printf statement, I have through the printf and scanf statement, I have read the values from the user. Let's take the values as 5 and 6. Then there is a printf statement, values before swapping, x is equal to 5 and y equal to 6, so that will be displayed on the screen. Then there is a function call statement to the function called swap. So here, instead of values, I am passing the address. Address of x and address of y are passed to the function called swap. So in order to hold that value, we are having pointer p1 and p2. So inside this function, I have written some statements to swap the values at p1 and p2 using a temporary variable. So after returning from the function swap, there is a printf statement. Values after swapping equal to x is equal to 6 and y equal to 5. So this is an example to swap two numbers using pointers. And here the values of the actual parameters, the change in the values of the formal parameters will cause the change in the actual parameter. So that's all about pass by reference method. Next is pointer expressions. The pointers can be used in expressions such as y equal to value at p1 into value at p2. This is a valid statement. Next is, you can also use the statement like sum equal to sum plus value at p1. That is also a valid statement. And next is, if you want to divide the values of the values at two different pointers, you can't use the statement like this, because slash star indicate can be considered as command in C language. So you have to put a space in between slash and star. So this is a valid statement. And pointers can also be used in relational expressions. So this is a valid statement. We are checking do pointers are equal or not. So this is also valid. Pointers, we are checking whether the pointers are equal or not. So these statements are valid. And these are the not allowed expressions using pointers. Pointers cannot be added. Pointers cannot be multiplied. Pointers cannot be divided. So another important point is, if we have two pointers pointing to the same array, then let's take the pointers p1 and p2. They are pointing to the same array. Then p2 minus p1. That will give the number of elements between p1 and p2. Okay. I will explain this using an example in the coming slides. The next topic is one-dimensional array and pointer. So let's take one example. We have the statement int d of 10 asterisk symbol b. So this b is considered as a pointer variable, and d is the array, and this d is capable of storing maximum of 10 elements. The starting address is d of 0 and the last address is d of 9. And by this statement, b equal to d. So this is an important statement connecting the array and the pointer. By this statement, we can establish a link between the pointer variable b and the array. So by this statement, b will hold the address of d of 0. So this is the statement to link a connection between the pointer variable and the array. Let's see one example. Here we have an array, and the values inside the array are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Then p is the pointer variable. By the statement p equal to a, we are making a connection between the pointer variable to the array. Then there is a loop, I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus, sum equal to sum plus value at p plus I. So the initial value of I equal to 0, so value at p equal to, it will take the value 10, then 10 will be added to the variable sum, then by the statement p plus I, the I will be incremented to 1, then it will take the next value, then this step repeats till I less than 5, then at the end, printf sum equal to percentage d, this will be replaced by the value in the sum, and we will get the output like this, sum equal to 150. And next is a program to find the length of the string using pointers. Here I will explain this program using two methods. In the first method, I have used only one pointer variable, and the second method I have used two pointers Let's see the first method. In the first method, the value of the data is stored in the array A, and Q is the pointer variable. By the statement Q equal to A, we are making a connection between the pointer variable to the array. Then this printf and scanf statement, we are reading the value from the user. For example, let's take the programming is the word that is entered by the user. Since it's an array, /0 will occupy in the last place. Then by this statement, I'm incrementing the value of I till the value at Q plus I not equal to /0. So after exiting the loop, if you print the value of I, that will give the length of the string. And in the second method, the concept is I have used two pointer variables, Q and P. Then by this statement, I am linking the pointer variables to the starting address. That is, initially Q and P are in this position. Then keeping the value of P in the first position and moving the value of Q till it reaches /0. So that is, this step is all about value at Q not equal to /0. We are incrementing, we are moving the pointer variable Q. Then after that, after exiting from this loop, print, there is a printf statement, length equal to we are subtracting the values between the pointers. Since Q and P are pointing to the same array, by subtracting Q minus P, that will give the length of the string. Then this is the program to arrange the letters of a word in alphabetic order using pointer. This has been asked in the university exam December 2019. For example, suppose the word is welcome, the output should be like this. The words in the letters inside the word should be in the alphabetic order. So that is the output. And for that, I am using a pointer variable Q. Then the character array is A. Then Q equal to A. By this statement, we are making a connection between the pointer variable to the array. Then from the user, we are retaking the values. Then this loop is used to get the length, and the length is stored in the variable N. Here, for the purpose of sorting, I have used bubble sorting. So for the statements are I equal to 1, I less than, and I plus plus, J equal to 0, J less than, N minus I, J plus plus. And in bubble sorting, we are comparing the value of A of J and A of J plus 1. So for that, here we are using the pointers. We are, the statement is value at Q plus J. We are comparing the value at Q plus J and value at Q plus J plus 1. If this statement is satisfied, we are swapping the letters. So after this loop, we are printing, when we print the value of A, our output will be like this. So that's all about this session. Thank you.